Look, we had a very good weekend, besides some incidents there and there. Of course, it's locked down, so we had very few cars on the road, besides, of course, the incident on Friday where a number of taxis, left the province to the Eastern Cape, and we are dealing with that matter.
All right, so, this was a taxi trying to transport people across the border. The difference between this Easter and last Easter must be incredible.
Yes, it is. The only accident that we experienced was that unfortunate, accident where the farm workers that were transported by truck were unfortunately, killed. Six were killed on the spot and three died in hospital. So those are the nine people that were killed in our roads this weekend. And of course, tomorrow I'll be getting a full report to get a total picture of what transpired this whole weekend. But I must say, Stephen, a number of the people of the Western Cape did heed the call. They stayed at home. And we want to continue to emphasize that people must stay at home because that's the only way for us to spread and to stop the spread of this COVID-19.
What kind of police operations were you managing? I presume you had roadblocks in several places.
Oh, yes. We had normal operations of roadblocks in various key areas. That is what we normally do. Our intelligence is telling us exactly where we should have these roadblocks on the weekend, like the Easter weekend. But of course, we also have experience, some people using alternative escape routes. And some of those people, landed in Eastern Cape. And I think we will be, adjusting our operations based on that intelligence. But I think the law enforcement agencies did really well this weekend to make sure that those people, the chance takers who were trying to break the law were apprehended. And as I said, tomorrow I'll be giving a full report because we have arrested a number of people who tried, their luck by, undermining the regulations.
Obviously, it's a very long border if you look at it between the Eastern Cape and the Western Cape. You can only block the roads. You can't really do much else.
No, that's true. That's true. And that is why I'm saying we're using our intelligence to know exactly where we need to be. But, of course, our traffic officers will always dispatch very thin, especially in a weekend like the Easter weekend. We've always known that despite the regulations that are in place, many people will try, to make their way to different provinces, especially the Eastern Cape, which is a very close province to us. And as I said, some of those people, were arrested, some paid fines, and some were released, with warnings, depending, of course, on the nature of the transgression. But we are really clamping down, very hard on those people who still continue to roam our roads when we have communicated a very clear message to everyone that they must stay at home.
Okay, and obviously you'll be able to maintain all of that through the lockdown. Are you expecting any problems to creep in, or do you think it's actually going to stay like this over the next 2 to 3 weeks as that we come to the end of the lockdown and the extension?
Well, look, I expect the situation to actually improve, and I think in the next couple of days, Stephen, we'll be seeing a much improved operation because many of those people who are taking chances have actually realized that we're in business. And I think our roads, will remain fairly, good. We've seen very few cars on the road. And we plan to keep it that way. And I must emphasize what those things, that those people who managed to find their way to Eastern Cape, who might have used, permits that obtained by really working with some of the SAPS members, will face the music. I was speaking to the provincial commissioner this morning, and she brought to my attention the fact that there are allegations that some of the police stations might have been in cahoot with those people who received those permits. Because as you know, Stephen, that in terms of the regulations, it's not the provincial Department of Transport that issue permits now. The permits are issued by police stations and magistrates, courts. And those are the people who are now issuing permits, but we are getting to the bottom of that.
All right.